Hello everyone. It's finally here. You guys have asked me repeatedly for the ID holder pattern and it is here. I'm happy to say that it is super beginner friendly. It is a scrap buster because the piece is literally only about this big. You can even do scrappy pieces if you want to. And it's very, very quick. We're also including SVG files for this one. So who's excited?
All right, so what makes this design different from all the rest? Well, you have your ID window that is accessible from the inside. People have said to me that they worry about their IDs falling out if from a pocket that's on the outside. So this gets tucked in to this pocket here and securely zipped shut. It's a perfect size for some folded cash and coins or maybe a chapstick. And to answer another commonly asked question, no, it will not fit a cell phone unless you have that old school flip a phone. But I don't know about you. I don't think I'd want the weight of a phone hanging from my neck. So just the essentials for this bad boy.
As you can see, the supplies are minimal on this because it is such a small project. You will have two exterior pieces cut out and two liner pieces cut out. I did add a woven interfacing to all of these quilt cotton pieces. The only difference is that the divider pocket has the Decoville light to just one side, and then I've left the other side without any interfacing. If you don't have Decoville light or you're not going to use it, you could possibly try a decor bond or maybe a Peltex, and then if you're going to use anything else, you may want to interface this. But this I've found in many, many makes that is sufficient and this doesn't need any interfacing. I'm going to show you how to do a wristlet strap and also a lanyard. And then we have our 5-inch zipper. If you're going to use a standard zipper, you're going to go ahead and cut off those stops and then you're just left with exactly 5 inches of the tape. Got zipper tabs and then our D-ring and or split ring. So let's go. I like to get my wristlet strap or lanyard or any of the straps done first so that when I'm done with the pouch, I'm truly done. So I'm going to show both, even though this pouch doesn't need both options. If you're going to do the lanyard, great. If you're going to do the wristlet, at least you'll know how to do it with this video. So I did add a woven interfacing to both pieces and I stopped just short of these edges because for the wristlet strap, we're going to do a continuous loop strap, and then this will decrease the bulk at that joining seam. And then for this one, we're not going to do a continuous loop, and I will show you why later. But you can either add this to the breakaway clasp, and you don't want a really bulky end, or when we sew the ends together, again, we want to reduce the bulk. So just keep the interfacing out of the ends. And then this is for the D-ring tab. So we're going to fold this, do the four-fold method, just like the straps. If you're using vinyl, cork, or leather, anything thicker, you're not going to do the four-fold method for these. You're going to just cut it only twice the width and then fold it to the centers. But because this is quilt cotton and it's thin enough, all of these will be the four-fold method. So we're going to do the wristlet strap option first because it is constructed differently than the lanyard. So I have a swivel clasp here and I'm using a 5/8 inch swivel clasp. So I times the finished width by 4. So that's a 2.5 inch wide strip. If you're going to do a 1/2 inch swivel, a 1 inch swivel, whatever you have on hand and want to use, you just multiply it by 4, that finished width. So I have to thread my swivel clasp on first to do this continuous loop sewing method. So I have the folds clipped in place and then I'm going to put them right sides together on these short edges and line up that edge there. So then we're going to go over to the sewing machine and we're going to sew this short edge across and then press it open and then refold it in place and you'll have that continuous loop. Then we can go ahead and sew down each side. All right, so I just sewed the short edge and then I'm going to continue to get it back folded. And then I'll clip that in place. So we have our continuous loop. And then as I'm sewing the edge, I will just move my swivel clasp out of the way. So I usually like to start and stop at that joining seam here.
I'll just pull it out a little bit and then I'll just slide on over and finish this other side. Trim all my thread later. A bonded thread with this, so I'm going to trim all these down and then I will singe them with a lighter just to kind of really secure them. So after this, then I will just slide my swivel clasp just below the joining seam. So it's hard to see on this black, but there's the joining seam, so I'll slide it so it's about a half inch above it. And either you can sew in the ditch right over that, or I punch below and add a rivet. So I'm gonna add a rivet to mine. So this is complete. I'm gonna set that aside. And as I mentioned before, the lanyard strap is constructed differently. We're not gonna do the continuous loop because we wanna make sure it lays on our neck and crosses at the bottom and doesn't twist funky or turn on its side. So I'm gonna go ahead and sew. This is the D-ring strap or your split ring strap. We do have to sew up both of those sides yet. But for the ID lanyard, I'm gonna go ahead and sew up both sides, but I'm gonna leave this edge raw and unfinished because I will show you how we're gonna add our hardware. So you may want to sew in a continuous loop because it looks nice. There's no raw edges like your wristlet strap, but I'm gonna show you why I would recommend not doing it that way. So as you can see, it lays nice and flat and splits down here to lay flat against your body. That is what you want. If you do a continuous loop, I'll show you, it wants to turn on its side like this and keep your lanyard like this in order to lay flat up on your neck. So if you get it to lay flat here, you end up with a twist. No matter how many times you try to smooth it out, you will have a twist no matter what you do. So if you don't mind that, and you don't mind that it hangs down on your body and turns sideways, you're certainly welcome to do this continuous loop. That doesn't bother you. But if you do want it to lay flat like this, I would encourage you to do it the way I'm gonna show you right now. I'm gonna show you two different ways to make the lanyard strap. One with a breakaway clasp, so I have that breakaway hardware here, and then one with it's just a loop of your fabric and then it doesn't break away if you're not concerned about that. But in a school setting, some people have said that they don't want anything around their neck unless it can break away. So first, let's just do the non-breakaway one, and I'd have this spare lanyard here. We're just gonna add the swivel clasp to it. So I thread it on to the bottom edge here, and then I wanna bring your attention up to the top. And sometimes if you have to put this around your neck to see that it's laying right, I would encourage you to do that. But you want it to lay where it's face up. Here you can see this underside, and then it loops down, and then again, you wanna see that underside. This will help it lay flat on your neck, and then you're gonna line up these bottom edges here, okay? I have my D-ring, or my swivel clasp, threaded the backside because we're gonna go ahead and line up these edges and sew a quarter inch across this bottom real quick. So you can see the loop will go nicely around your neck and then it's overlapped on the bottom. This was threaded down. I did sew across the bottom. So now we're gonna go ahead and flip it inside out, if you will. And because I did the four-fold method on this fabric, there isn't truly a right and a wrong way. So if you do it any other way, you will want to be mindful of a right, an underside, and a exterior. So I'm going to tuck this down under here. And earlier I had mentioned that I like to leave the interfacing out of this area because it cuts down on the bulk. I had taken it all the way on this strap, so it's pretty bulky. But if you kept it out of this small edge here, it's really hardly noticeable at all. So now once that's tucked down in here, I'm gonna go lay it flat on itself again and sew a row of stitching here or add a rivet. And then you can just make sure that you still have this nice loop up here
and it will lay nicely on your neck. I added the rivet to mine, and I can tell that it's gonna lay nicely on my neck because this lays flat, and then I've got the little loop here. So I can't actually like lay it flat on itself without it doing that. So if you did the continuous loop method, you'll see that it will lay flat. That's how you know this difference, okay? So now let's go to the breakaway option. I'm gonna show you how to do that. So the breakaway clasp option is done the opposite way. You want the loose ends towards the top. We're gonna take the swivel clasp and thread it on. And depending on where you want that breakaway clasp to land, if you want it smack on the back of your neck, then you would measure this perfectly so the sides are equal. If you don't want the breakaway clasp on your neck and you want it more to break away more on the side, then determine that placement and then clip your D-ring or your swivel clasp in place so that it stays in place. But so we gotta make sure that it's laying flat here because that's how we want, and then we're gonna arch this around so that it does lay nicely on our neck and doesn't twist, and I kind of clip it like that so you could see how it lays flat. You have the option, I've seen the lanyards where they have a split ring on the back too. If you carry keys at work or whatever, you can certainly add one of those. So I'm gonna do mine perfectly symmetrical so it lands on the back of your neck. So I'm gonna line these up so they're equal. Clip this down here so it's flat, spread them, and then twist them like this. And I'm gonna clip it so that I can make sure I'm on that it goes nicely around my neck. So I have these breakaway clasps that are a no-sew option. These have little gripper teeth on them that you put on those raw edges. And then this slides in to one of the clasps. So you can see it has a little bump here and this has a hole. So those would slide right in and clip in place. Same thing with this side. There are sew options where it's more like a D-ring where you would thread this around your the loop it has, and then you would sew that down, and then it would still have a similar clasp where it could break away. All right, so I'm gonna take these little gripper teeth and wrap it around one of the loose ends here. You can add some glue if you're worried about it, if you think that's gonna pull away. So keeping it, following it this way, determine your right and your wrong side, because you'll see this clasp has a bump out on this part, and this part, it's shallow. So if that's gonna go that way, then I need to make sure that this is up the correct way with the hole versus down this way, or I'll flip my straps again. All right, so I'm gonna slide this into the hole. Sometimes I'll push it down on the table to get a little leverage. Okay, so then those holes should line up and then you can't pull it out that way. All right, so go back to laying it flat and how we're gonna want this to go. So now I need this bump to be this way when I add the other crimp to this side. It has a bump on both sides, so this part doesn't matter, but this part does. So following it so that it loops correctly like this. And this is the hole, it's gotta go on this side. So I'm gonna do it this way. Push it in there, get your clip in place, and then now you see the bump. There you go. And I just added a rivet for this one, so our straps are done. Let's move on to the zipper and interior divider pocket. As I mentioned before, there are many ways to install a zipper. Some people will leave this end turned at 90 degree angles and then the tab on this side. I wouldn't recommend doing that for this particular pouch because when we go to turn our pouch right side out, we wanna be able to hide those interior seams. So we really do need two zipper tabs. So first things first, I'm gonna take the right side and lay it down right side together on top of the zipper tape. And I'm gonna sew a 3/8 inch seam allowance. And then we're gonna encase this raw edge by folding it back on itself. finger press it open like this, and then I'm gonna fold this so that these kind of these edges meet here, and then fold it again. So it should go just beyond this first fold so that you do catch it in your top stitch here. There you go, trim off these threads, and we're gonna repeat it with the other side. So I just wanna point out that when you fold it over, it's butting up to the edge of the zipper tape on both sides, so you're not losing or adding any depth to the zipper, so it's still 5 inches, okay? So now let's move on to our interior divider pocket. I'm gonna sew with the décolleté portion side up, and I will start at my turning hole along this bottom. I did the markings here. I'm gonna start here, go all the way around, and end here. I'm gonna sew just at the edge of this. I don't wanna catch the décolleté in my seam, but I do want to take that 1/4 inch seam allowance all the way around. So these were right sides together. I'm just gonna kinda trim off the corners just a smidge. The seam allowance is so narrow. I mean, if you want to just trim it down a little bit around the corners, feel free. And then turn it right side out through that turning hole along the bottom. I usually like to have a little screw head, or screwdriver around to turn it, help turn it right side out. All right, and I realize it is a pretty narrow seam allowance, but I'll do the first side tucked around the décolleté light and then iron that. And then I will take this other edge and tuck it in as well, lining up those edges. I'll just clip this to hold those folded under. Then we're going to go to our machine and we're going to top stitch all around, closing the hole. It's going to be 1/8 inch from the edge. Set your divider pocket off to the side. We'll need it in the next step. So next, grab your two exterior and two liner. We only need one exterior and one liner, so I'm gonna set the other two off to the side. And we're gonna install the first portion of our zipper. So creating a zipper sandwich, we're gonna take our zipper, and with the zipper pull to the right, we're gonna lay it face up on top of the lining centered. If you find it easier where you wanna go ahead and fold your zipper in half and mark these centers, and your fabric in half, mark your centers, or if you're just like me and you wanna eyeball it. So it's face up just like this, and then you're gonna take your exterior and sandwich it right down in between and sew 1/4 inch across. So I have my zipper sandwiched in between these two layers, and I'm gonna sew 1/4 inch seam allowance. If you're using a number 5 zipper, you're certainly welcome to do that. Do not take a bigger seam allowance. You're still gonna do the 1/4 inch seam allowance. Otherwise, you will mess up our measurements of our zipper pocket. Once I come about halfway and I can feel my pull underneath there, I'm gonna slide it out of the way and continue to sew. Okay, so you'll notice so far, you saw 2 exterior and 2 liner, and neither one had those cut lines for the window on it, and there's a reason for that. I found, after doing this many times, that you wanna cut the exterior and the liner as one versus pre-cutting the holes and then hoping everything lines up. You'll thank me later, I promise. All right, so we're gonna press this and top stitch. Okay, so now we're gonna cut them as one. So take your main pattern piece and line it up along the bottom curved side and clip it in place so it doesn't shift. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and trace this box on my fabric. I don't mind that this is not a removable pen because we're not gonna even see this pen mark because it all gets folded to the back. So draw those lines. And then take this off, and I would encourage you to still keep them clipped together so that they don't shift. So I usually just kind of fold it in half to get started here. and get my scissors in there. And I'm cutting both layers as one to that line. Careful with these small snips that you don't go beyond those lines, because you really do want all of them symmetrical. So your box is a perfect rectangle. So I just want to show you that you could see I did my best to keep them perfectly lined up, but my liner is just shifted a little bit to the right. So if I had already pre-cut my boxes, that little bit would affect the boxes lining up together. So cut them as one. This next step, I can't emphasize how helpful a craft glue stick is to keep your quilt cotton pressed and held in place. So I love this for this step. So I would do the exterior first, just because that is the portion of the window that you're gonna see, and I like to make sure I can get the window lined up perfectly with the exterior. So I'm folding them back all the way to the snip lines back here, and then the craft glue stick kind of helps that heat set it and hold it down. Just go all the way around, repeating this. So now I want to flip this up, and then as I'm gluing the lining down, I'm really using that top as my guide. So before I go heat set it with my iron, I want to just make sure that it is nice and even. So then kind of double check, looks good, and continue that whole process with the other sides as well. They line up, looks good. You can see how even an eighth inch off, how it seems like no big deal in a seam allowance or in any other portion of making this wallet, but when it comes to the window, it makes all the difference. That's also why we've kind of decided for that, even though we're offering the SVG files for you guys, not to have this window pre-cut, because I'm trying to allow for human error, and I've made this so many times, and even I didn't line it up perfectly well, and I clipped it, and I positioned it, and I still managed to have it a little off. You really want to cut them as one. So, looks good. Now I'm going to put my vinyl window inside, and we're going to sew that box. So just separate the two, and I'm gonna take my clear vinyl and I'm gonna tuck it up all the way to that edge there, centered. So just make sure you got equal amount on of the vinyl past all windows, but it is cut large enough that it's not gonna be missed when you sew it. So then I'll lay it back down on, and then I'm gonna take my long prong clips just to kind of hold it all together. So when we go to our sewing machine, we're gonna sew all around this outer box, about an eighth inch from that edge. You're gonna wanna go real slow on this one because you just want a nice even stitching. So right now you can't see the black under there, but if you see it popping out a little bit, I'll take my finger and give it a gentle tug, but also just make sure that it is right there, because if you're sewing so close to the window, you don't wanna accidentally miss the lining. Stitch, just give myself a little wiggle room there. and make sure I can see my liner under there. Next, grab your divider pocket, flip your pocket over, and we're gonna center the top edge of this with the edge of the zipper on each side. And then you should have equal amount on all the bottom and the sides while with the top, the edges lining up with your zipper tabs. So just like that. And then I'm gonna go ahead and clip this in place so it doesn't shift. And then from the right side, I'm gonna take it back to the machine and I'm gonna sew, it's gonna be an eighth inch, quarter inch from this line. So I start up at my top stitching line here near the zipper. I'm gonna start there, go down, pivot along the bottom and go back up ending at that stitch line. So this is about an eighth from the edge. This is gonna be another eighth inch from this first stitching. Alright, so you'll notice that we have a little bit of a ledge here along all sides. We want that. That's important for the very final step. Before I move along to finishing the pouch, I really do want to make sure that my card fits nicely before I finish my wallet and realize something's wrong. So, looks good. I'm happy with that. So, now we're going to go ahead and add our D-ring here. So, we made our D-ring tab earlier. We're going to thread it through and pinch it in half, just like this. I like to center it on the vinyl on this left-hand edge. Some people like it up top. You're welcome to put it wherever you want, but I do put it on the side of the zipper pull. So if your zipper pull's over here, then I would put it over on this side. So the raw edges face the raw edges, and the D-ring is lined up with the center of the vinyl. And I will have a little bit of an overhang because I like to line up the edge of my D-ring with the edge of my zipper pocket. And I'm going to base that in place right there. Now we just finished the other side of the zipper. So we're going to create another zipper sandwich. So we're going to lay the top edge of your zipper face up on the center top edge of the liner. We're lining up these side edges. And then we're gonna take the top and lay it right side down on top. Again, lining up that straight edge and these sides and clip in place. Then just like before, we're gonna take it to our machine and sew a quarter inch seam allowance all the way across. Press this really well with our iron away from the zipper. Press it and then we'll top stitch. All right, home stretch, guys. We are almost done. We're gonna go ahead and open up our zipper so that we can sew our pouch together. If you're gonna add any label, whether it's in your side seam or on the back here, you're gonna wanna do that now before we do this next step. So now we're gonna go ahead and fold this perfectly in half at the zipper tab here, lining up these edges so that they are perfect together. I'm gonna do that on the opposite side as well, right here. And then clip everything else in place, lining up all your edges. So this final seam allowance isn't as important as it is to sew just next to this divider pocket. I know it can be kind of hard to see because we used black stitches on black fabric, but I'm gonna start right next to my zipper tab up here, back stitch, and then we're gonna just ride along this edge, going around the bottom and ending back here. And then you can go ahead and just trim any rogue threads, but we're not trimming our seam allowance. Did you open your zipper? Open your zipper if you haven't done that yet. So we're starting right close to that zipper tab. So I'm using a very narrow foot, if you've noticed. If you haven't used a narrow foot, I would swap out to your zipper foot or a narrow foot at this point so you can get really close, because I'm coming up to my D-ring here as well, and I wanna get close to that. Because you'll find that when you do D-rings in any of your sewing, if you don't sew right up against it, it twists over time, and that drives me crazy. I hate seeing a twisted D-ring. Trim these little rogue threads, but I'm not really trimming down my seam allowance. I noticed that this side seems, I took a bigger seam allowance than this side. Again, it's more important that it lines up with this divider pocket because that was centered on our window. And you could take a little bit off the corner, but you don't want to trim it really far down so we can hide them behind this in the next step. Alrighty, now we're gonna go carefully turn it right side out. So the vinyls on that side, I like to really, if I need to manhandle, I do it from this side. So I push those corners in from this side and then try and turn it as quickly as possible so that the vinyl doesn't stay crinkled very long, because you can't iron vinyl. But you also want to be mindful of your zipper. You don't want to pop any stitches. There we go. So grab my screwdriver here, use it to push out those corners. You'll notice I always round my corners on all of my pouches because we don't want to be really aggressive and poke these out and then you've got these really pointy corners. It's not a good look, I hate that. So I always round those corners so we can have a nice finished, gentle rounded bottom. So I go under here and I push the seam out so it's flush with the zipper tab here. Same thing, give it a good push there. Press it with my fingers. So now you're probably worried about those raw edges inside because it's kind of unsightly. We don't really like raw edges. So what you're gonna do now is you're gonna put your hand inside and pull up on the divider pocket. You're gonna pull that away from the wall and the seam. And then once it's away and away from the seam, you need to push out your corners a little bit better, do that. We're gonna push those seams in flush behind it. So I use my fingers to push it behind it, and then I will center the divider pocket right on top of it. You're gonna do that along the whole perimeter so that by the time you're done, you will not see any raw edges. And if you did two zipper tabs, you won't see it. So this part can be a little finicky if you've got really big hands for a small pouch, but it really gives you that finished, polished look on the inside. Still see a little bit of my liner, pop that in. Of course, if I would have used a black interfacing, it would have been a moot point. All right. There you go. So now you open up your zipper pocket and your ID goes on that inside. Add your lanyard strap. And you're done.